Dear friends, welcome to the science class. So in the last class we were discussing about the work and energy topic. In that energy topic we discussed about the kinetic energy. So in that kinetic energy we discussed about what about the kinetic energy as well as the formula, mathematical form of the kinetic energy, as well as we solved some numericals related to the kinetic energy. So in today's class we are going to discuss some more numericals. We are going to discuss about the text questions which are given in the page number 152. So let us consider the first question here. What is the kinetic energy of an object? So already discussed that kinetic energy of an object is nothing but it is the energy stored in that object due to its motion. It is an energy acquired by that object due to its motion is nothing but what? It is the kinetic energy. Now if you see the second question here. Write an expression for the kinetic energy of an object. So what is that expression? We know that kinetic energy is mathematical form, that is nothing but Ek, that is nothing but kinetic energy is equal to half mv square. So that is nothing but it is the expression for the mathematical expression for the kinetic energy. So that is nothing but Ek is equal to half mv square. That is the second question which is given in the page number 152. Now let us consider the third question which is nothing but a numerical one. So what is that question here? The kinetic energy of an object of mass m moving with a velocity of 5 meter per second is 25 joules. So what will be its kinetic energy if its velocity is doubled? And what will be its kinetic energy if when its velocity is increased by 3 times? When it is the velocity of that object is increased by 3 times. So what they are given here, in the problem statement they are given the kinetic energy of an object when it is moving with uniform velocity 5 meter per second. 5 meter per second, that kinetic energy is equal to how much? It is equal to 25 joules. So this problem can be solved in two ways. So first way is directly seeing the factors which is increasing and analyzing that factor and analyzing the effect of that factor on that kinetic energy, the first way. Or second way, we are going to solve this question by numerically. So first I am going to solve this question numerically, then I am going to tell how to analyze the answers by using the factors which are changing here. So first what we have to write, the given data. So what is the mass of the object here? Mass of the object, which is equal to how much? Which is equal to m, is equal to m kg. So we don't know the mass of the object, therefore m is equal to m kg. Right. So then what they are given here? They are given the velocity of the object, initial velocity of the object. So that velocity of the object that is nothing but v is equal to 5 meter per second. 5 meter per second. When object having mass m kg, when it is moving with the 5 meter per second, it is going to acquire 25 joules of the kinetic energy. So that kinetic energy is also given. So kinetic energy, that is nothing but Ek is equal to how much, which is equal to 25 joules, which is given as 25 joules. Right, so what you have to calculate, we have to calculate Ek, let this be the one kinetic energy when velocity is double. When velocity is double. So let this be the Ek2 or Ek1, which is equal to question mark. Again, what we have to calculate here? We have to calculate Ek2, that is nothing but kinetic energy when velocity is increased or velocity is tripled. That is nothing but triple, it means what? It is increased by 3 times. So it is equal to what? Ek2 is equal to question mark. Ek2 is equal to what? Question mark. Right. So, first what you have to calculate here, we have to calculate the mass of the object, and by using the mass of the object, we are going to calculate the kinetic energy in the first case and kinetic energy in the second case. So we know that Ek is equal to, kinetic energy is equal to 1 half mv square, right? of mv square. So what is ek given here? It is equal to 25, which is equal to 1 by 2 into m. What is the value of v here? It is 5 square. It is equal to how much? It is equal to 5 square. So that is equal to 25 is equal to 1 by 2 into m into 25. So 25 ones are. Therefore, 1 is equal to 1 by 2 m. Therefore, m is equal to what? If this division comes to the LHS side, it will become multiplication. So 2 into 1 is equal to how much? It is equal to 2 kgs. So therefore, mass of the object is equal to how much? It is equal to 2 kg. So next what you have to calculate here, we have to calculate the kinetic energy acquired by that object when the speed is increased, when the speed is doubled. So in the first case, when velocity is doubled, when velocity is doubled, so that velocity becomes what? V is equal to 2V, which is equal to 2 into V already given as 5 meter per second, so it will become 10. So 2 into 5 is equal to how much? It is equal to 10 meter per second. Now we have to calculate the Ek here. Therefore, Ek1, kinetic energy in the case where velocity is double. So that is equal to half, mass is 2 already calculated here, 2 kg into 10 square. So 2 ones are. So what is the value of 10 square here? It is equal to 100. So Ek1 is equal to 100 joules. Ek1 is equal to how much? It is equal to 100 joules. Next we have to calculate the kinetic energy acquired by the object when velocity is tripled. So therefore, when velocity is tripled, therefore Ek2 is equal to again. So what will be the velocity here? V is equal to, it is tripled, means it is going to increase by 3 times. That is nothing but it will become 3V. 1 time 1V, 2 times 2V, 3 times 3V. So therefore 3V is equal to 3 into 5U, which is equal to how much? Which is equal to 15 meter per second. Which is equal to 15 meter per second. Again, by the formula, therefore Ek2 is equal to half m into v square. So that half m is the value, is nothing but 2. And what is the value of v here? So it is 15 square. So that is equal to how much? 2 ones are. 15 square is nothing but what? It is equal to 225 joules. So therefore Ek2 is equal to how much? It is equal to 225 joules. Right. So the kinetic energy at initially it is 25 joules and the mass of the object is becoming 2 kgs. When we increase the speed of that object, when we double the speed of that object, then the kinetic energy of that object is equal to how much? It is equal to 100 joules. When we triple the speed of that object, that is nothing but the velocity of that object, then the kinetic energy is becoming 225 joules. So it is the answer for the exact question number 3. Right, I told you I am going to solve this question in two ways. One way by the numerical data, I am going to solve by mathematically. So again by using the factors. So we have the formula here, that is nothing but Ek is equal to half mv square. Right, while discussing about this, in the last class I told you that mass of the object is not going to change. Since it is constant only, kinetic energy is directly proportional to the square of the velocity. It is directly proportional to the square of the velocity. As velocity increases, kinetic energy is also going to increase. As velocity decreases, kinetic energy is also going to decrease. So see here, Ek already given how much? It is equal to 25 joules. As well as here, if you see here, kinetic energy is equal to what? It is nothing but it is v square only. If you remove the constant value, since mass is not going to change, mass will remain same only. Therefore, if you take here Ek, so what is happening here in the first case? Velocity is doubled, so that v is becoming 2v. Velocity is becoming double. So if you put that value here, so it will become 2v whole bracket square. So Ek is equal to you can take equal to here. 2v square is equal to how much? It will be equal to 4v square, right? 4v square. So ek is equal to, we already know that v square is nothing but ek. So let this be the ek1, this will be the ek1. So if ek is nothing but what? V square is nothing but what? Ek. So 4 into ek here. So this v square is nothing but what? It is the kinetic energy only, initial kinetic energy only. So the kinetic energy which is presented initially, it is increasing by 4 times when we increase the velocity by 2 times. So if you put the value of ek here, that is nothing but 4 into 25, you are going to get the value as 100 joules. So you just write, I am going to get the value as 100 joules, right? So here also the answer is 100 joules. So when you double the velocity, 4 times the kinetic energy is going to increase in the square factor. In the same way, if we increase the velocity by 3 times and the kinetic energy of that object is going to increase in the square factor of that velocity. If it is increasing by 3 times, then what will be the kinetic energy? It is going to increase by 9 times. It is going to increase by 9 times. So if you take the initial velocity, initial kinetic energy here, it is equal to 25 U. It is equal to 25 U. And if it is increasing by 9 times, so we have to multiply here by 9. So 25 9 is how much? It is equal to 225 joules. So we are getting the value as 225 joules. So like this, either you are going to solve this way or you are going to solve this way. Depending on the mark they are going to ask in the examination. If they ask for the 1 mark question, just directly use this factor. If they ask for 3 or 4 marks, just write them. Solve that question by mathematically by using the formula, first by calculating the mass of the object. So this is about the question number 3, which is present in the 152 page number in text question. I hope this is clear. Now let us discuss about the potential energy. So now up to this point we discussed about the kinetic energy, that nothing but it's due to its motion. Now next we are going to discuss about the potential energy. For that reason we are going to take some example to know what is the potential energy. So first I am going to take an example of the rubber band. Right. So when you take the rubber band, when you stretch the rubber band, what will happen? It is going to get stretched. So if you leave that rubber band after stretching, what it is going to do? It try to come to its initial position, its original position. So it tried to come to its original position without the help of anything. We are helping that thing? No, we are just stretching that thing. But when we leave that thing, it is trying to come to its original position. That is nothing but it is doing some work. It is doing some work. So we already know that for doing a work, what is required here? Energy is required. So it is getting energy. So from where does that energy it is getting? Who is supplying the energy for that thing? And what type of that energy it is getting? So when you stretch it, when you try to stretch that rubber band, at that time we are going to apply some force. That is nothing but we are transferring our energy into that rubber band. So whatever the energy we are going to transfer to that rubber band, that energy is going to store in that rubber band when it is stretched. When it is stretched, it is going to store in that rubber band. When we leave that rubber band, what it is going to do? It is going to try to come to its original position by using that energy which is stored while stretching that rubber band. That energy it is going to use for the come to its original position or original state. In the same time, if we take a slinky here, spring. So what we are going to do here, we are going to stretch that spring. Right, after stretching that spring, what it is going to do? When you leave that spring, it try to come to its original position, original state. So to try to come to its original state, what it is going to do? It is going to do some work. Again, for that doing work, it required energy. So from where does that spring is getting energy? While stretching that spring, we are going to do some work. While doing the work, we are going to transfer our energy to that spring. That energy is going to store by that spring for the purpose of doing work while coming into its original state or original shape. Right, it is storing. Again, in the same manner, when you compress that spring, applying some force, we are going to do some work again. When do that work, when you leave that spring again, it tried again come to its original position by what it's doing, by expanding it, by stretching itself. So again, from where does it is going to get energy to do that work? While compressing that thing, we are going to apply some pressure or force. That force is going to store in the form of energy. And that stored energy is going to help that spring to come into its original position. In the same manner, some other activities are given, some other examples are given. Just read it and just try to analyze those things. I am going to take another example here. So this is the example of a water container. And this is open tap. So here no water is present. So there will be no movement of the water. Means what? There will be no work done. Right, I am going to close this tap and I am going to put some water here. Right, so water is stored here. Right, when you open this tap, what will happen? The water starts to flow here. Actually, initially it is at rest position, there is no work is done here. When you open the tap, what will happen? From that tap, water starts to go out. So when water starts to go out, what is actually happening here? Here a work is done. Work is happening here. So we know that for the work to be done, what is required here, what is essential here? It is the energy essential here. So from where does this container or this water is getting energy? When water is stored in a container, it is acquiring some energy. When open a tap here at the below, that energy is going to transfer. Because of that energy, this water continuously starts to flow. Because of that thing, here the work is done. So again, if you see here energy is stored. Here in the same case, we take spring also, here also some energy is stored. In the same manner, if you take rubber band, there also some energy is stored. So that energy which is stored in those things is nothing but what? It is the potential energy. So that potential energy can be defined as the potential energy. It is potential energy. So if you go by the vocabulary, by English, what do you mean by potential? Potential is nothing but what? It is the capability to do work. So we don't know the capability. In the same way, we don't know anything here. But still it is doing the work. Why it is doing the work here? Since it is storing some energy in it. So in the same manner, potential energy is nothing but capability which is stored in that container or in that object due to some work is done on those things. Here it is storing in the form of the water. So that is nothing but it is the potential energy. Here is also by due to the expansion it is storing some energy. Here also due to the expansion and as well as due to the compression it is storing energy. So that is the capability of those things to do the work. So that type of energy is nothing but what? It is the potential energy, which is denoted by the EP. So EP is nothing but potential energy by R. AK is what? It is the kinetic energy. Right, so we are going to derive expressions for the potential energy. So we are going to take the object having mass M and kept at height H. So while doing that thing, While doing that thing, we are going to keep the object at height h. While doing that thing, we are going to do some work here. We are going to do some work here. We are going to take that box and we are going to take that box to some height. While taking that box to some height, it is acquiring some energy. It is acquiring some energy. That energy is nothing but what? It is the potential energy. So it just can be given as potential energy of an object at some height. Potential energy of an object at height, at some height. Right. Again, if you see here, we are doing the work to make that object, to take that object to some height, we are doing some work. That work we are doing in opposite to the gravitational force. Gravitational force. So that this object is going to acquire some energy. This object is going to acquire some energy. Alright. So that energy is nothing but potential energy. So how much work we are going to do here to take that object to some height, that much energy is going to store in that object. Store in that object. Right, if you take this height, we are going to do work, this much work. If you want to take further more in height, then we are going to do some more work. So that some more work is going to add into the some more potential energy in that object. So we are going to derive an expression for that thing. Right. Therefore, here we are doing the work to keep that object to some height. So what is that work here? We know by the definition work is nothing but what? It is the force into acceleration. It is nothing but what? It is force into the displacement. Force into the displacement. So what is force here? If we take the force here, what is force? By the Newton's second law of motion, that is nothing but M into A. M into A. But if you see here, the work is doing here, whatever the work we are doing here, it is against the gravitational force. It is against the gravitational force. If we take some height, then there will be acceleration due to gravity is going to come. So instead of A, we are going to put G here. Instead of A, we are going to put G. Since it is due to gravity. Since it is due to gravity. Since we are taking the object to some height, that means gravitational force is going to act on that thing. That means acceleration due to gravity is going to come into the action. Instead of that acceleration, we are going to take acceleration due to gravity. In the same manner, whatever the ma is there is nothing but the, it is the weight of the object. It is the weight of the object. W is equal to m into g, we know that. As well as, what is s here? S is nothing but the displacement. S is nothing but what? It is displacement. So what is the displacement here? It is nothing but, it is equal to height. So we are going to take the object from here to this height. That means how much displacement is going to happen is nothing but what? It is the height which where we are going to keep that object. So S is equal to what here? S is equal to height. So it is in vertical direction. Vertical direction and therefore displacement is equal to height where we kept the object. Height where we kept the object. Right. So by using those two expressions, putting those expressions into the first expression, what we are going to do here, what we are going to take, f is equal to, if you put the f value as m into g, since a is equal to g here, you put that value, it will be mg. And what will be the value of s here? That is nothing but height. So that is nothing but what? W is equal to mg h. W is equal to what? It is equal to mg h. So we are doing this much work to take the object from the ground to the some height. Take the object from ground to the some height. Right. Now whatever the work we are going to do on that object is going to store that work done in the form of energy. In the form of energy. So whatever the work we are going to do here is equal to the energy. So that energy is nothing but what? it is the potential energy, so therefore AP is equal to W is equal to R, which is equal to mgh. It is equal to mgh. Therefore kinetic energy AP is equal to mg into h. AP is equal to R, it is equal to mgh. Right, so this is nothing but it is the mathematical expression of the kinetic energy. That is nothing but what? It is mgh. And we can tell that it is the product of the weight into the height. It is the product of what? Weight into the height. Right. I hope this is clear. Right. Now let us consider on which factors does kinetic energy depend. Now if you take mass as the constant, we know g is constant here. G is value is 9.81 meter per second square and it is not going to change. So g is constant. So on which factors AP is dependent? AP depend on the, I can write here by AP that expression, that AP, we know that g is constant, so that AP is directly proportional to the mass of the object, as well as AP is directly proportional to the height of the object. Since g is constant here, as the mass increases, if you take a different object, if the object having more mass, then the kinetic energy of that object will be more. If you keep the mg constant here, if the height of that object is more, then it is going to store more amount of potential energy. Right, therefore, this statement can be given as mass increases, the potential energy of object increases. In the same manner, as height increases, the potential energy is also going to increase. And potential energy of the object is also going to increase. That is nothing but vice versa here. Here also it is vice versa. So ulta, opposite of that thing. As mass decreases, potential energy is also going to decrease. As height increases, potential energy is going to increase. As height decreases, potential energy is going to decrease. Right. So this is about the potential energy when an object is kept at a height. Right. So in the next class we are going to discuss further about the potential energy, as well as we are going to discuss some numericals related to the potential energy. So up to that point, thank you, take care, stay well, stay home.